Welcome to Ikimaki. So the reason why I'm not saying hello and I'm saying hello is because not just because we are having this inter-solar conversation in Gujarat, but also because we are having this conversation with a German-based company. We have Mr. Tanmay Dwari, who is the CEO of Axitech India. He's joining us. Sir, could you please tell us about your company?
So, Guten Tag.
Guten Tag. Yes, that is it.
Yeah. So, as I mentioned earlier, Axitech is a German-owned German company. We have our headquarters in Stuttgart.
Okay.
And we have been in the module solar photovoltaic module business since the year 2001. So, we are probably one of the oldest manufacturers in the world.
Okay.
We are currently number one solar module brand in Europe. So, that's kind of a brand, you know, badge that we like to hold to our heart.
Okay.
And proudly say that. In India, the Indian subsidiary that I'm heading, we established the Indian subsidiary in 2018.
Okay.
And since then, we've done, I would say, a decent amount of business. When I say decent amount of business, it's decent amount of quality business. We are not trying to be the number one in the Indian market. We're not trying to be the number 10 in the Indian market. But there is a specific segment who understands quality products.
Okay.
And that segment we want to cater to.
Okay. So far, how many modules have you supplied in Indian market?
So, in the Indian market, overall, I think we've done around 150 megawatts.
Oh, that's very nice, actually. That's
yes, considering that we are a European company and we started quite late in the Indian market. I mean, we had huge players already in the market. But yes, I would say this is a considerable feat for us, having the team that we have. And we have a certain amount of brand recognition now.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, since you're talking about manufacturing capacity, and we have also, since you're talking about manufacturing capacity, I would like to ask you, do you have any manufacturing units in India?
We do not own any manufacturing units throughout the globe. It's a part of a business decision. It's a part of a business strategy.
Okay.
But we are manufacturing solar photovoltaic modules in India with our partner locations.
Okay.
We have done around 55 megawatts in India with our Indian partners, manufacturing partners, where we use a manufacturing facility. But the quality control, the BOM, the bill of material control, the specification, everything is controlled by us. So any factory that is manufacturing solar modules with the brand name Axitech has same or similar specifications and same quality standards.
Okay, so besides India, how many countries have you supplied your product to?
So Axitech supplies throughout the world. We have subsidiaries, directly Axitech owned subsidiaries in Australia, Brazil, USA, Turkey, and Germany, of course. But in general, we cater to around 65 countries throughout the world that we have supplied projects. So we have done around 2.5 gigawatts throughout the world.
Okay. So with the your company is Europe-based, that is from Germany. And India has recently emerged as a great solar market. It's the second it ranks second in the list of most
in terms
solar
of volume, yes. In terms of volume,
definitely.
Probably.
After China.
China, so, or maybe some other, maybe we are number two or number three.
Yeah.
But yes, we have a significant amount of volume.
And also, Middle East is emerging as the heartland now of solar energy. So, what do you think the global trend going towards in terms of solar?
So, overall, see, every industry has its own cycles, you know, up and down. It's like a sinusoidal wave. Sometimes it's up, sometimes it's down. But right now, what I see specifically, let's say if you're talking about the Middle East, we do have a huge potential there. People are getting conscious about climate change. And it's no longer a luxury, but this is something that we have to do. Otherwise, we will not survive probably the next 25, 30 years.
Definitely.
That everybody has understood. Even hardcore climate change deniers are seeing that
the impact of it. Yeah.
So nobody, I mean, yeah, it's a given. You have to change. So the easiest way to deal with it is go with renewable energies, and that too solar is very quick to manufacture and deploy, considering the capacities that we have. Specifically in India, we know there are very aggressive policies, and we would, and I'm hoping that there will be better manufacturing facilities, more capacities in India.
Okay.
But largely, yeah, this is policy driven, and I think it's all the politicians in the world. They should come together, and they have come together, and they're
The recent COP summit was an example of it.
Exactly.
India promising that we'll be going net zero emission by 2070, which is a very big target to achieve. And with all these commitments coming in that we have to have 450 gigawatts of energy capacity by 2030.
Yeah.
So, do you think it offers a great prospect of scope for companies like you, model manufacturers like you?
Yes, it does. So, technologies will change. Probably the modules that you see here, which is the latest technology right here.
Yes.
It might be obsolete in another 2-3 years.
Yes.
Highly likely.
It's a very dynamic market.
It's a very dynamic market. The technology keeps on changing. There are new models available. So, we will, for the next 20-30 years, I don't see this market dying down. So, we have a future. A lot of other people also have a future. A lot of other new people will enter this market. They will bring up new innovations, new technologies. And let's hope, they are sustainable. They are as sustainable as they are promising it to be.
Okay. You mentioned about your product. Would you like to talk about it?
So, this is the latest product that we have. It's the 540 watt peak module. It's a massive powerhouse. Yeah, it's a massive powerhouse. And
so, I would like to tell our viewers that it's a very busy day at Intersolar.
Yes.
And we are having this conversation in the middle of the hallway. So, there are a lot of people coming in, which is why we are getting disturbed. But I'm sure this interview is going great. So, please continue.
Yeah. So, this is the module that we have, the 540. It has a multi-bus bar technology, MBB. Where you have the solar cells with more than 9 or 10 bus bars. The idea is that it brings in more reliability in terms of if you have micro cracks on the module, micro cracks being cracks, invisible cracks, which you can't see with your eyes. But at the same time, in the background, you can see it through a specific test.
Yes.
And if a module with micro cracks is installed over a period of time, three to five years, probably that module will be burnt off. It will get burnt. So, the idea is that to prevent those things from happening, we have the multi-bus bar technology.
Okay.
This is,
and 20.89% that is the
efficiency of the solar module.
Okay. And durability is a very big concern as far as solar modules are concerned. So, is there anything that enhances the durability?
Exactly. The multi-bus bar technology actually enhances the durability.
Okay.
So, you don't... There is a phenomenon called hotspots, wherein there will be a spot on the module and the spot will burn off.
Yes.
So, when you're using this technology, that will not happen. Or it's highly unlikely that it will happen.
Any technological roadmaps in the future?
Probably what we are looking at is, right now, what the cells that we use in commercial production, it's P-type or a positive type semiconductor, where the positive side generates the power. Whereas the newer cells that will be coming up will be N-type, where the N-type semiconductor is on the front.
Okay.
And these N-type cells, they don't have any degradation.
Hmm.
So, they don't degrade over a period of time. Unlike the P-type cells, in the first year, they will degrade by 2 to 3%, and that is where you find the generation loss. With the N-type, so I think that is the next immediate change in technology that we will see in the next 1.5-2 years.
Okay. You recently mentioned that there is a political bottleneck that you are facing, or maybe we can say that what are your expectations from the regulators and policymakers in India as a German company or as a company outside India?
See, I'll try to answer this a little diplomatically.
We would understand that.
Yeah. But what I would say is that what our market lacks in India is policy consistency. There are duties which will be coming in. There are duties which government has announced. I feel it's great. I would want people to manufacture solar modules in India, install it in India, sell it to the rest of the world. I'm absolutely for it. But there should be clarity when you're getting it, how much you're getting it. You should not be changing policies every 3 months.
Okay.
What happens is when you do that, is that your investors become wary. They say, how will I put my money in India? If the policies are changing every 3 months, I don't know how to calculate my returns on investment.
Maybe that's why China has an upper hand as far as policies are concerned, because their market is very static. You know, their policies are very static because of the kind of government. But in democracy, as far as you are concerned about it, what would be your expectation?
I would not say that Chinese policies are consistent. They also declare things suddenly. But the problem is, or I would say the advantage that they have is, they have a huge market base in itself. And they have huge manufacturing capacities, and literally they are arm twisting the rest of the world.
Yes.
Right. So you can't argue with it. With us, since we are primarily importers and buyers right now, and I would say for the next 3 years, we would be primarily importers and buyers.
Okay.
For us, who have a stable market, stable solar market, we have to be consistent with what we declare.
Okay. That is very important.
Yeah.
What do you think Indian market provides to you as a manufacturer?
So it's a huge market. It's a huge market. Sheer volumes of it is what is, you know, giving us support. We probably are not making as much money in India, but the volumes that we do, the turnovers that we do is helping us. I mean, let's say, I will put it this way, India is not the not the most quality conscious market. We had this discussion, but considerably, I mean, I would say there is still a segment who understand, and overall when people are gaining the, you know, experience with solar, they are understanding that you have to invest in certain quality products, you have to invest in certain quality designs for your investment to be successful.
Okay. Any final concluding thoughts for our viewers?
Buy our modules. We have ready stocks. Yeah. So for us, it's quite important. See, what happens in the Indian market is you give advance to XYZ manufacturer or distributor or dealer, and there are delays, and your project goes for a toss. Whenever you're going with, no matter whether you buy from Maxitech or whether you buy from any of our competitors, be sure to vet whether that person has stocks, whether that person can actually manufacture and deliver to you on the right time at the right prices and at the right quality. This is what I would like to you know, tell people.
Okay.
So you have to balance out everything. It's not always the money. You know, sometimes you can, in most of the times, you can be penny wise and pound foolish. Don't do that.
Thank you so much,
right.
Mr. Tanmoy, for joining us.
My pleasure.
Thank you, guys.